जी की सत्र नंबर एक उसको प्रारंभ करते हैं। उसके जो विषय विशेषज्ञ हैं हमारे रिसोर्स पर्सन हैं प्रोफेसर रमेश चंद्र शर्मा जी, वो हमारे साथ जो है जुड़ चुके हैं। मैं उनका हार्दिक स्वागत और अभिनंदन करता हूँ। वेलकम यू सर। वेलकम सर।
नमस्ते सभी को।
वेलकम सर।
जो भी हमारे इस केंद्र के साथ जुड़ा है वो सर के बारे में पहले से ही जानता होगा, क्योंकि सर जो है हमें अपना मार्गदर्शन और अपना अमूल्य जो है सहयोग हमेशा प्रदान करते रहते हैं, और हमारे इस मार्गदर्शन के लिए, उनके इस मार्गदर्शन के लिए हम कृतज्ञ हैं। और साथ ही साथ जो है जो हमारे विशेषज्ञ हैं प्रोफेसर रमेश चंद्र शर्मा जी, बहुत सहज सरल एवं विविध विधाओं के धनी हैं। वो कभी जो है थकते नहीं है, कंप्यूटर के साथ रहते रहते उनके कई सारे कंप्यूटर के गुण जो है आ गए। कई बार सबके बारे में जो है सर से जो है मिला हूँ, देखता हूँ तो बात करता हूँ, तो जैसे कंप्यूटर कभी बोर नहीं होता तो हम कभी वर्कशॉप में सर से एक ही क्वेश्चन देखते हैं, बच्चे या हमारे पार्टिसिपेंट बार बार पूछते हैं, तो सर भी कभी जो है बोर नहीं होते हैं, वो हमेशा जो है एक अलग तरीके से उसको जो है बताना चाहते हैं। सर जो है अम्बेडकर यूनिवर्सिटी दिल्ली के अंदर जो है प्रोफेसर के रूप में कार्यरत है, साथ ही साथ देश विदेश बहुत सारी संस्थाओं के साथ सर जुड़े हुए हैं, बहुत सारे शोध पत्र, बहुत सारी पुस्तकें, और साथ ही साथ जो है अभी जो इस समय कोरोना के समय में जो ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन की जरूरत है, उस समय सर अपना मार्गदर्शन द्वारा बहुत सारी ज्ञान गंगाओं को प्रारंभ करने में सहयोग कर रहे हैं, और साथ ही साथ जो है अपने इस विशेष ज्ञान द्वारा सर जो है लोगों को विशेषज्ञता प्रदान कर रहे हैं। सर आपका स्वागत है। आपके बारे में दो बातें कह के मैं जो है सत्र अग्रसारित करने के लिए आपको निवेदन करूंगा। परिचित है आपसे केमिस्ट्री के आयन एवं रसायन, परिचित है आपसे केमिस्ट्री के आयन एवं रसायन, चमत्कृत है कंप्यूटर साइंस के एरे स्ट्रक्चर्स एवं लेटेस्ट एप्स एंड डिजाइन, संप्रेषण का अंदाज सहजता से करते हैं, रिलेटेड कंसेप्ट को कंबाइन सरलता से समझाकर वो करा देते हैं, आपको फील डिवाइन। थैंक यू वेरी मच सर एंड वेलकम। वेलकम एंड आई विल होप दैट यू विल क्रिएट द डिविनिटी इन दिस सेशन एंड आई सरेंडर दिस सेशन टू यू, प्लीज सर।
थैंक यू जितेंद्र जी।
वेलकम सर।
नमस्ते है सभी को। एक तो आप लोगों के साथ ना बात करके बड़ा अच्छा लगता है, इतनी पॉजिटिविटी फैला देते हो आप कि उसके बाद कुछ बचता नहीं, तो ये बहुत अच्छी चीज है आप लोगों के साथ हमेशा बात करके, आपसे मिलके। और अभी जो पहला सेशन था अभिषेक सर, उसमें इतनी मतलब कई बार सोचते हैं कि किस व्यक्ति के पास ज्ञान का कितना भंडार है, कि आप सुनते ही जाओ। और मुझे आप लोगों की एक बड़ी अच्छी चीज लगती है कि आप किसी भी चीज को इतना पॉजिटिव वे में बोलना हो, वो डेफिनेटली आप लोगों से उसकी एक बहुत अच्छी सीख मिलती है कि कैसे पॉजिटिविटी को मेंटेन किया जाए। सो थैंक यू वेरी मच अमिता जी, आपने एक बार फिर मुझे चांस दिया और काफी अच्छा नंबर है, लगभग 200 के आसपास हम लोग हो गए। और ये एक 3 दिवसीय प्रोग्राम है, आप सभी जान ही चुके हैं। इसमें आज हम कुछ ऐसी वेबसाइट्स को देखेंगे जहां पर हमें अपना कंटेंट मटेरियल, क्योंकि ई लर्निंग के अंदर हम सभी को देयर इज एन एसेंशियल कंपोनेंट फॉर ई लर्निंग इज दैट वी नीड टू हैव सर्टेन प्लेटफॉर्म ऑन विच वी कैन माउंट अवर कोर्स, फॉर द कोर्स वी नीड सर्टेन काइंड ऑफ कंटेंट and content can be of various nature, it can be textual, it can be multimedia includes image, sound, animations, simulations, a wide variety of things are there which are needed for that. So we need a learning management system, some sort of a platform. Means any platform on which we mount our course material is called as learning management system. Although there are some other names also like content management system, and then there are some products which are a combination of LMS and CMS. So they call themselves as LCMS, learning content management system. Then we need certain tool with the help of which we can connect with our students. Like now we are connected with you using Google Meet, but there are certain other products also in addition to Google Meet. Why we are using Google Meet now? Because of one, number one, it's positive feature is that it can handle large enrollment. You can see now we are around 200, so that way. And secondly, nowadays, just very recently, since I think 10 days, 2 weeks ago, the Google announced, and particularly there was some commercial interest also because the Zoom was getting bad criticism, and then they try to overtake them. So Google has announced that now the Google Meet will be available to the general Gmail user also. If you open your Gmail now, your normal Gmail, not the institutional Gmail, on the left side of your screen, you will find a new button of Meet, join and share a class, schedule a class like that. So this Google Meet is available to everyone now. The only challenge is that if you are using institutional, like our university, Lal Bahadur Shastri University has installed G Suite. So G Suite can handle up to 250 enrollment at one time. And your personal Google Meet will have around 100 of the participants that way. But otherwise, you can record it, you can share your screen, you can do all kind of things using that. So you need one learning management system to mount your course. You need content for your course. You need a tool for meeting with the students. So that is called as the web conferencing tool or something. And then in addition to those, we need our course mate, because nowadays the mobile devices, they are very much, I can see here now some of our friends like Vidya Dharji, Jagdish Prashad, Krishna, and what is from Gurukulam Bhuvaneshwar, it is Gurukulam BBR is written, I presume. Like there are some of our friends who have connected using their mobile phone. Means, you know, the mobile devices, they have become ubiquitous, present everywhere. It is the easiest device which we use. So we need to pay attention to that if we are creating something for online. And nowadays, it is called the emergency remote teaching, which we are doing. It is not online that way. It is a form of online, but the proper name, it is called as the emergency remote teaching. Because you never know. Now the UGC says that we have to teach online. But just 2 months ago, 1 month ago, before this pandemic started, only those universities which were in top 100 NIRF, they could go online. You know, so the situation has forced all the universities. And as you must have heard the address of the Prime Minister, the situation may continue, means we may have to live with it. And in that case, this online learning is going to be, you know, more prevalent now. It was there. It is not that nobody was using the many of the universities, not as per se in pure online learning way, but as a blended learning approach. All of you have been using technology. I know that many of you are from the names. I know that we have met earlier. There are some friends also of mine in this group currently. And perhaps some of you might have attended the previous workshops attended by the Lal Bahadur Shastri University previously. And we have conducted so many ICT-based program. So I know that we all have been using online teaching learning methodology, online teaching learning tools in our teaching. But that way was in a way more of a complementary or supplementary kind of source, because our main teaching was still focused on face-to-face kind of learning. So with these are the requirements, and today we are going to see the one of the requirement that if you have to create a course or if you have to teach a course, you need access to the content material. Now, the content material, then in that case, if you are using it, you just cannot go to the internet, find something and use it. Because then it may have certain challenges, and the biggest challenge which you all know is of plagiarism, piracy, stealing the content of someone else. You think that, I know that many of you are authors, you have written so many articles,
you are the authors of good books. How do we feel if that someone uses our material without, means unauthorizedly, no acknowledgement to our work, or not obtaining our work through legal means, means just sort of taking the material and not highlighting. And that way it is a very serious thing, and there are serious consequences also for the employees. In many, I know in many universities, the people, someone is saying my audio is not clear. Is it so? Is it for everyone that the video is not clear? And perhaps you know, because it is the first session, thank you Ishika, it is the first session, sometimes you may feel that when I'm presenting my screen, you are not able to see my screen. In that case, please remember that when you hover your mouse pointer over the windows, you will see a pin button, pin button there. So if you click on that pin button, and in that case, what will happen, that whatever image, whatever screen you will pin, it will stay on your screen. In that case, your screen will not change. Otherwise, in that case, this software does, let me tell you a little bit about this Google Meet or the similar kind of softwares. These are artificially intelligent enabled softwares. So any person who will speak, currently I'm speaking, to my window will be the main window. But when I'm speaking, suppose Jitendra ji also wants to say something. So the software will see that if some other person is speaking for more than 2-3 seconds, that will become the main window, and my window will go to the side at that time, because the software is giving space to the speaker at that time. So if you, in that case, if sometimes it happens, and it may happen, I know that, in that case, you need to make the main window as the pinned window. You can pin it. Means if you just hover your mouse pointer, you will see there will be three buttons. You will see the pin is active. वो जो आप नोटिस बोर्ड पे पिन लगाते हैं, जैसे दैट काइंड ऑफ पिन. देन द अनदर वन इज ऑफ माइक्रोफोन. इफ इट इज म्यूटेड, इट विल बी थ्रू ए स्लैश, एंड द वन विल बी द, इट मींस ओनली द होस्ट कैन यू नो एक्सपेल सम पर्सन फ्रॉम द मीटिंग इफ देर आर नॉइस क्रिएटर्स. आई वांट टू टेल यू दिस बिकॉज यू मे बी यूजिंग दिस सॉफ्टवेयर फॉर योर ओन टीचिंग पर्पज. सो एज ए टीचर यू शुड नो दैट हाउ टू हैंडल दिस दिस सॉफ्टवेयर्स. And these are good softwares even for creating your video lectures also. You just create your session, have your PPT uploaded on the screen. There is no need for you to add any student. You just alone there, start the recording button. At present, if you see on the upper left corner of your screen, there is a red button REC written on that. This means that now the recording is in session. The session is being recorded. And that way you can create your own video lecture also. You don't need any high-end, high-tech, other kind of software. These software, they are wonderful softwares which are used, and the recording will be saved in your own drive. So that way you can use it. Okay, so let us go ahead with our session. And today I want to deal with certain, I have to just get away from that. I need to change my screen. I think now you are able to see my screen. Okay, friends, the purpose here is कि आप लोगों के लिए ये जानना बहुत जरूरी है कि कोई भी चीज जो भी इंटरनेट पर अवेलेबल है, that is not free to use. It doesn't make us to use that because of the copyright restrictions. And that's why we need to be careful that we select only those materials which we are officially entitled to use it. And उसके लिए हम एक license होता है जिसको हम बोलते हैं Creative Commons licenses. मैं आपको simply एक बार दिखा देता हूँ. I won't go more into the details of that, but they are very important for you to know. Creative these are called as Creative Commons licenses. ये Creative Commons licenses हैं. अब कोई भी, क्योंकि अब आपको बड़े हैवीली तरीके से आपको अपना उसमें यूज करना है उनको,
let me see if I can take you the photograph of there. Okay, let me show you the image. Say, for example, this is the image. You can see here on the side, there are six kind of Creative Commons license. There is one question which software someone is asking me, which is this software. Actually, this is the website. It is called as the Creative Commons website. जिन्होंने हमें alternative license दिए हैं कि आप किसी भी आप अपने मटेरियल को भी क्रिएटिव कॉमन्स मटेरियल का लाइसेंस दे सकते हैं, कोई किसी को पूछने की जरूरत नहीं है आपको। इनमें से ये जो छह लाइसेंस है, इनमें से आप कोई सा भी लाइसेंस यूज कर सकते हैं। और आपको भी यदि कोई मटेरियल ढूंढना हो तो भी आप कोशिश ये करें कि ऐसा मटेरियल देखें जिसके ऊपर ये वाला लोगो लगा हुआ हो या तो ये इस किस्म का आइकन आपको दिखेगा वहां पर, और नहीं तो आपको वर्डिंग लिखी दिखाई देगी CCBY, ऐसे वर्ड CCBY होगा। जैसे आप ये देखें इस वाले स्क्रीन में, ये CCBY जो लिखा हुआ है ये, अब इनका मतलब क्या है? अब ये देखें, ये ऊपर से नीचे तक ये जो ग्रीन से लेकर रेड तक जो बना हुआ है, पहले वाले जो दो हैं CCBY और CCBYSA, इनका मतलब है कि ये मटेरियल मोस्ट फ्री है। ये आप इसको एक स्पेक्ट्रम की तरह मानकर चल सकते हैं, दैट ऑन द टॉप अबव CCBY देयर इज पब्लिक डोमेन एंड बिलो CCBY NCND, वो जो रेड टिप है उसके नीचे आ जाएगा कॉपीराइट। मींस इस स्पेक्ट्रम से आप अपने मटेरियल की जो स्पेक्ट्रम है, जो उसकी सीमा है, वो आप अश्योर कर सकते हैं। ऑन वन एंड देयर इज पब्लिक डोमेन, पब्लिक डोमेन मटेरियल्स आर दोस लाइक रामायण, महाभारत, मुंशी प्रेमचंद की कहानियां एटसेट्रा व्हिच आर इन पब्लिक डोमेन, नोबडी इज होल्डिंग द कॉपीराइट नाउ एंड यू कैन यूज देम फ्रीली, यू कैन मेक चेंजेस इनटू इट, यू कैन रिवाइज इट, यू कैन मेक डेरिवेटिव आउट ऑफ दैट लाइक दैट। और दूसरे सिरे पर होता है कॉपीराइटेड मटेरियल्स व्हिच आर कॉपीराइट प्रोटेक्टेड बाय दैट। इन बिटवीन दिस we have these six kind of licenses. CCBY makes state that यदि आप इस material को use करना चाहते हैं, so पहले वाले में CCBY है, उसके बाद CCBY SA है। इन दोनों का मतलब है कि आप केवल जो author है उसका, जो owner है उस content का, आप उसको acknowledge करेंगे। और उसका मतलब ये भी है साथ के साथ, यदि आप चाहें तो उसका commercial use करना हो, उसको edit करना हो, उसको revise करना हो, वो काम भी किया जा सकता है। दूसरा, फिर उसके नीचे जो दो लाइसेंस आपको दिख रहे हैं जिसमें लिखा हुआ है CCBY ND एंड CCBY NC, ND stands for no derivative, means you cannot revise, you can update that, and NC means you cannot make a commercial use of that, non-commercial. NC stands for non-commercial, ND stands for non-derivative, that way, and SA stands for share alike. It means that if you are using that material on which the license is CCBY, you can use that material, you can make a commercial use of that, you can revise that product, but again you will have to give the same license to that material. It will still be remained as CCBY SA. In case of others, there are conditions in which you can change the license. You have used some other material, you have created your own material, and using that you can then give a new kind of license to that. So my purpose of showing this image to you was that to let you know that if you use these material which are Creative Commons materials, these are called as open license. They are with open licenses. It is always better to use these. They are the most safe because there will be no plagiarism in that case. But the condition is that
voice is not clear.
You still need to acknowledge the source, that who owns that material there. So that way you have to use it. And now let us now come to those sites which we can very well find some of our materials. I will start with some of the common resources. Say, for example, in Delhi, we have Kalindi College. Okay, is it coming up? Let me see.
online study material, what happened? Okay, here. Oh, this is the website of Kalindi College on which they have uploaded. You can see the data from here. Total uploaded is around 2000 materials. And today's upload 6, yesterday's upload 27. And here you can see that the content material is available. Say MA Sanskrit, BA Sanskrit, perhaps most of you who are from Sanskrit, you can find something useful for you from here. And please pay one attention to this thing is that you may try to search material what is available. There may be certain situations in which you are not able to find material which you want. In that case, there is a golden opportunity for you to create that material and share it with others, because it is something like that. Whatever we are using is available to us because someone before us, they were so danveer that they shared their knowledge with us. And similarly, हमें भी ऐसा ही करना चाहिए कि हमारे पास जो ज्ञान है दूसरों को देने के लिए, तो यदि हमने कोई लेसन लिखा है, हमने कोई नॉलेज क्रिएट किया है, we must share it with others, and that's why the knowledge grows, and that's why we are able to use these products, use this content which have been created by others. अब ये देखिए दुनिया में सिचुएशन क्या होती कि यदि हर कोई नॉलेज का मटेरियल, हर कोई आर्टिकल, हर कोई बुक यदि कंप्लीटली कॉपीराइट प्रोटेक्टेड हो जाए तो हमें क्या करना पड़ेगा? हमें उसको खरीदना पड़ेगा. क्या हमारे पास इतना मनी है? लाइब्रेरीज में आप बात करके देखिए, उनका बजट जो है वो कम होता जा रहा है दिनों दिन. हमें जो टेक्स्ट बुक खरीदनी होती है, क्या हर कोई स्टूडेंट, क्या हर कोई लेक्चरर सारी सब्जेक्ट्स की अपनी टेक्स्ट बुक खुद अपने लेवल पे हर साल परचेज कर सकते हैं? इट्स ए वेरी डिफिकल्ट थिंग. एंड दैट्स व्हाई द अल्टरनेटिव लाइसेंसेज वर क्रिएटेड फॉर दोज पीपल हु आर इन ए वे नॉट एबल टू परचेज दैट मटेरियल. दे डोंट हैव द फंड्स विद देम. देन एंड दैट्स व्हाई दिस फिलोसॉफी ऑफ शेयरिंग it gained popular, and that's why many of these, you are using Firefox, you are using Moodle, you are using Java, you are using so many products, they are open source products. यदि सारे का सारा paid product हो जाए तो आप कोई भी software use नहीं कर पाएंगे. हमारे most of the computers के ऊपर Microsoft का pirated software चलता है, but the company, if they track you down, then they can drag you to the court. That is the implication of that. So there are these certain resources. Let us see, say for example, I'm just browsing. You can see the list which is there, and means this is not my subject, but I'm just here. Modern Sanskrit literature, Swatantra Sambhavan Shlokas. This is the description. This is a paper. This is the teacher's name here, and here you can whatever you want to see. You can see this material, and you can see it from there. How they have used and shared those materials with them. This may be in Hindi, and similarly, you can select from there. These are the course materials for that subject. Then you have say MA or MA Sanskrit. It is yet to be uploaded on here. So this way you can you can browse this website. You can see here it is for science subjects is there, economics, English, journalism, geography in Hindi. Those of you who are from Hindi, they are, the material is available for Hindi. You can see it is for Ghalib, for Hindi ki kavitaen, etc., kahanikar, and or natak mein Hindi. You can see this material, and it is a MS Word document which you can it is downloaded on there. So this way you can browse this website and find that how good it can serve your purpose. There is another resource for using text based sources just in our neighborhood, is the National Repository of Open Educational Resources. This is one of the good platforms where you can find useful material for you. You just click on repository, and there you can see there are e-books, there are e-courses, there is e-library into it, and here you can find digital e-books, and these are all available to you for use. Here you can see there are documents, there are interactives, there are audios, there are videos, there are images. And then if you want to search for certain images, the documents, you can select the language, in which language you want. और यहाँ पर आप देख सकते हैं आसमीज में है, हिंदी में है, गुजराती में है, मलयालम, मणिपुरी, मिजो. सो देर आर वेरियस लैंग्वेजेस. इन दोज लैंग्वेजेस द मटेरियल इज शेयर्ड एंड यू कैन सेलेक्ट योर क्लास और इस देन यू कैन सी इट, यू कैन क्रिएट इट. इट हैज हाउ द मींस दिस इज द ऑडियो बुक. For there, if you click on it, then it will start, you know, playing, and then you can listen it. Similarly, you can select the other forms, like say e-courses, e-books are there, and then this is say on psychology. You can click on it, and then here it shows you what are the things, and then you can see here. This is the license CC-BY-SA. It means you are free to use this book because it has been shared, and you, if you want that, you need some portion of it, then that can be you know, used in that way. So this is another resource which you can use it. There is another site which we called, that is Karnataka Open Educational Resources. This is created by the teachers from Karnataka, and this is a free portal. It is a collaborative resource created by the teachers, although they have written it for the Karnataka, but anyone can use it. Means it's open for us, and here you can see that all the content created and uploaded is licensed as OER by using CC-BY. It is a, so it means that it allows you to revise this material if you think that you need to put it, use that material for it. And here you can see the subject portals, the materials. Say for example, let us see in Hindi, and here it is Hindi ka itihas. You can find Hindi ke shikshan, I think that is teaching of Hindi. Then subjects, curriculum, textbooks, question papers, grammar, vyakaran there, and here is the Karnataka textbook book topic there. So much of the resources available which you can explore from here. So you can see similarly for English and mathematics. So you can explore that way. Similarly, one more product is there. This is Telangana OER. Looks like the website is slow. Okay, maybe it will come up soon, so I can go to the next page. And there is this. Now we will see some of those websites on which you can find textbooks, you can find other kind of content material used by them. Here they, it may be basically for you in language because they are non-Indian. Excuse me, is there some question?
Sir, what are the copy and listen?
What are they?
Chandra is presenting.
Okay, here you can find, say, like explore it based on subject, and you can see the so much of the subjects it offers you. You can search your textbooks for biology, chemistry, computer science, education, English, fine arts,
geological, history, information, nursing, health sciences, political science, psychology, sociology, etc. Can you please who is Dinesh ji, can you please mute your microphone?
तुमने वो कर रखा है क्या?
Yeah, the device was coming for that. Okay, here say for example, this is on psychology, sociology. From here, you can find the open textbooks. You can make a Google search also. Say like this is the book, General Psychology, and this is accessible with optical character recognition also. Files here which can be used from there. So say for example, you can click on this book and it allows you, you can fully download it. And here is the accessible version. If you want to download as the PDF, you can download as the MS Word and then its instruction. And you can see that it's so far it has been downloaded this book by around 14,000 downloads already there. And here you can see the license. It is Creative Commons license, Discipline Psychology here. So this way you can find by subject authors. If you know that you want to find some particular author, you can try it here. And here it is by material type. By material type means what do you want to search? You want to search some class slides, open course, open textbook, assessment means questions, some quizzes, something, or course syllabi. You want to create something for your own subject on your own course, and maybe you would like to find that and use it that way. So this is the site which is called as Galileo Open Learning Materials. Okay. So now another one. This is a very good, a very popular platform called as Matlock System. It provides you access to the curated online support materials by which are created by international community of educators, learners, and researchers. And you can see here, you can search by keyword, by URL, by ISBN or something, or you can simply browse their course portfolio, the members, and anything you can search from here. It has a very huge database. And in fact, if you think that you want to add some material or you can create, you can join. From here, you can sign up in the upper corner and create your ID on this site. And you can also contribute to this community. From here, you can see that there are various disciplines, materials is available on them. I presume that most of you are from humanities, social sciences, like that, so or education. So we can just say like click on humanities. And you can see that there are around 10,000 results for it. And here there are the materials. You can see these are the listing on the left. On this, there are so many materials for history, journalism, philosophy, religious studies, classics, like that. And then you can see the material type. Whatever you want to see, you want to search for open textbook. There are around 1400 open textbooks. There are quizzes, there are reference materials. There are even, you can find courses also. You can find case study, you can find assignment. There are so many things available which you can think that if there is something good for you, you can, means you need to make a search on that. You need to know that how you can make a good search for this. So this website is Merlot, a website. Now, another one which they started with it is the MIT OpenCourseWare.
They actually, this MIT was the first one in the year around 2000 when they started with this. Now it is around 20 years earlier than they are still popular. And there you can find the complete courses by visiting their website. You can make new courses, you can find online textbooks, you can find audio video lectures, and you can find even complete course by going to their you can browse by topic, browse by department. Here you can browse by department, browse by course, browse by topic, and say like use that. Here it is department. You can see School of Sciences, Chemistry is there, management courses are there, humanities courses are there, economy, history, literature, music, art, political science. You can select on that. And then there are these popular courses. You can see it tells you that to what level it is undergraduate. And then there are graduate level courses. You can see it shows you a large about, say, like writing about literature. And here is this, you can view the full course. You can click on view course, and here is the course. If you want, you can cite. From here, you can see its syllabus, the readings, the assignments, and download course materials. You can completely download this course material. Here you can click on and start downloading. And you can, this MIT has allowed you that you can use their course material completely. Here you can see that it is available on the web free of charge. All the materials is available to you with more than 2,400 courses available. Here, on the premises of open sharing of knowledge. And you can see the license. Even you can revise this course material. You can update them. You can modify them depending on your own local needs if that situation is with you. There you can explore that. So there are so many things, and then you can find interesting by department wise, by topic wise, by course number. Here you can see if it is, like if you want, say for example, want to go for say fine arts, it will select, then it will show you the subtopics into it. In fine arts, which subtopic you want. Say for example, you want to go for music. So you select for music, and then in music, what do you want? You want to search for the history of music, music performance, music theory, or something like that. You can go there and select it. That way you can select it. So now let me show you another site. This is OpenStax. You can find the context material from here, like the mathematics, science, social science, humanities. These are the peer-reviewed, openly licensed, 100% free material there. So these books, say, for example, history. And then you can see here, the selection is there. And you can then explore, and here you can see it is CC BY license. CC BY license is the most flexible kind of license, which allows you that you can modify this content, and even if you want to print this book, you can download this PDF from here, and if you want to print it, and then maybe you can distribute it to the needy people there. You can go ahead with that. So here, now there are certain websites which are good for researchers. Oh, this website is not opening. Let me try to search it in other way. Here is a reservoir of Indian thesis.
It looks like their website is not working, but you can make a use here. It is showing you that it is a reservoir of PhD, they deposit their PhD thesis and make it available for you. You can find it department wise, you can find it here wise, or you can make a search using keyword there. And these are the, it's on in Flipnet, Shodhganga. It is a mirror site. Let us see if it comes up. Looks like the site is slow. In the meantime, let me show you another website. This is the one of the very popular, the National Digital Library of India. And here you can see it is showing you the message that the resources can be accessed without being logged in. But if you can create your login, then it will give you some extra facilities there. And for school students, you can choose school button, you can browse by source. Here, these are the instructions. But here are the resource types, subject domain, feature subject, and what you can display there if you want to log in from there and say, what do you want to search? You want to search technical report, you want to search some here, monograph, technical, law judgment, thesis, books, more than 64 lakh books or thesis, which you can see. So here, these are the authors, subject wise, education level, subject category. And here it shows you what you want to search. Say, for example, on social science, you can see more than 7 lakh resources are available, which have been contributed on this website. Completely essay, labor policy, economics. You can see here it is showing you how many results are there in this time. And then you can, if you want to search for articles, you can search for articles. You can want to search for books, theses, video lectures, audio lectures. It allows you to search. Say, for example, you want to search for something on languages. Here, these are the things for you on languages. Odia, linguistic, UGPG, it is showing you who is the author, what is the level, and Brahm ki Utpatti. So this may be in Hindi, and you can click on that. So here, it is downloading it. It means it downloads on your local machine, and then you can go from there by using that. And similarly, you can make a search on the thesis, the PhD thesis, which have been submitted by various universities. And then from here, it is a good resource for you that you can make use for your related literature survey, and you can find it. Similarly, educational degree, it offers you for what level you want to search. And you can see the whole variety of degree levels. It offers you. It offers you the difficulty level. It is asking you the education level, like for class 5th to 8th, 9th and 1st to 4th, 11th, 12th, career, UGPG, for which level you want to search the material. It is offering you the file format. You want to search for, say, text file. You want to search for PowerPoint presentations. You want to search for PDF. And then accordingly, you can see all the PDF will come. Here it is offering you the languages, in what languages. And you can see that not only the Indian languages, it offers you the material which is in foreign languages as well. So you can keep looking. There, Konkani is there, Latin is there, Nepali is there, Dutch is there, Punjabi, Russian. Okay, here we have in Sanskrit. There are around 1,700 resources which are in Sanskrit also. This is by MS University of Baroda. And here the colleagues, they have submitted. This source is by InFlipNet. It means it is the research work. From here, you can see that who has uploaded what. and the critical studies of Kalki Puran, there Dharmraj in Mahabharat character, somebody has Narsimha cult on Sanskrit literature, you can see, and it will open. Here you can see the PDF, because it is a PDF material. If you click on that, then it will be opening, and here you can read about it. And similarly, you can say it is declaration and the content. You can search and decide that what is good for you. Okay, so this way, this is a very good resource for you, where you can search materials for you. Some of you may be, you know, talking about nowadays everyone speaks about skills. So there is a good website from where you can, this is called as Skills Commons, and you can read it from here. Your free and open digital library of workforce training materials. So using this website, you can find a specific particular skills based and the various projects which have been, you know, there is the material type, and you can see the number, in what number the materials is available. You can see syllabus, presentation, assignment tool, quiz collection, reference material, drill practice, illustrations, graphics, etc., and how the people, they are using it around the world. Wherever the people, they are using it, you can find materials related to that. So here it is, subject. You can make a search, and on particular what collection, what you want. And then here, if you want to search from some institute or credential type, are you searching for something for diploma level, bachelor's degree level, a certificate level, associate degree level? Accordingly, you can see the content which is available to them for that level. You can find it from there. Okay, then there is another site which is very good for college level students or school level students. You can see this is Science Activities. They are very good books, but they are for science, because you know here it is Science Activities. Biology, chemistry, physics, say you click on any resource and it will show you the biology. You can find chapter 1, chapter 2, and you can click on that, anyone. It's all freely available to you. And these are the interactive websites. Say, for example, you want to see for food chain practice, you can click on it and it will allow you, it will run. So here, play the game. So here it is asking you parts, bird, flower, caterpillar. So here I will keep bird and then caterpillar here. So here and here. See this one, and then so that way, here is the big urchin we have to start. So who eats what? Say for example, the fruit, mouse is eaten by snake. So that way, you can means these are good for interesting for students, to let them know that how they can, you know, through animations you can explain the concepts. And here you can say vocabulary. On vocabulary, You can find materials for that. You can health, language, arts. Those games are available, and you can make a good use of those resources from where you can find them. Okay. Another source. Here, this is the open access thesis and dissertations. This is the here research and scholarship thesis and dissertations. To find here in the upper right corner, this is the logo for open access. Wherever you will see, you can make it that these are the open access materials. And here you can see, you can make a search here by the name, author, subject, something, and literature. Then these are the you can, from here you can search the results on literature. There are so many of the total searches which it has. From the date you can find, from the university, by accessing university department, you can see here on the left, you can select department wise, degree wise, level wise, language wise. Here you can see from country wise, those countries which have contributed to it. And then you can see, you can search for the results. Okay, so there are so many of these websites available to us from where you can search those good material for you. Okay, then I'll show you another resource which is again quite useful. This is the British Columbia campus, the university in Canada, and you can make a search. You can create open textbook, or you can use what has been created by them, and these are all freely available resources. You can adapt, you can use in your institution, you can explore, you can find, search, and browse their collection. Here you can see, you can browse, find textbook, open source. Here you can make a search into it and suggest a book, publishing guide. Here, and here you can see the license at the bottom of the page. The content of this website is under CC BY. CC BY, which means that it is the most flexible kind of license, which allows you to make commercial use of that, which allows you to make derivatives of these products. It means you can download some content from it, and if you think that you want to revise it because it suits your purpose after revisions, then it allows you to do that with these materials on that. So here I think I can stop presenting, and if there are some questions, and perhaps maybe we need to have some little break. After that we will start our next session. Now if there are any questions, then
hello sir.
Okay, Radhakrishnan.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Sir, Sachin Kumar Verma from DS College Aligarh.
Okay.
Actually, sir, in the beginning, you were talking about any video software by which we can create any video easily. So I couldn't hear the name of that software. Which one?
Okay. For video creation, there are various softwares. At that time, I was telling that, like, we are currently interacting using Google Meet. So you can use Google Meet. You can use Zoom. The Zoom meeting. Or you can use WebEx, those things, or Skype. They are the web conferencing tools, you can use them. But otherwise, to record, you can use Screencast-O-Matic, which is an online software. So there is a variety.
अच्छा आई थिंक आई डिड आई टेल यू लेट मी शेयर माय स्क्रीन अगेन एंड लेट मी डिमॉन्स्ट्रेट समथिंग देन प्रेजेंट नाउ ओके विंडो वेयर इज माय स्क्रीन रनिंग अप Yeah, the video recorder is there. Okay, so you can use Loom. This is screen recording. You can use screencast
automatic. Unable to see the screen, sir. Screen sab dikh nahi rahi hai, sir.
You refresh your page perhaps because I can see that it is visible.
Okay, now.
This is screencast automatic. You can use this.
Yeah.
There is another one which is screencastify. So they are there. You can use them.
Okay. Thank you very
much. Hello, sir.
Afternoon, sir.
Hello, sir.
Okay, let me see the. Yes, please. Hello? Speak. Otherwise, I'll check.
Hello, sir. Namaste, sir.
Yes, yeah, we can hear you. Namaste.
Yeah. Sir, मैं प्रिंस कुमार गुप्ता लखनऊ यूनिवर्सिटी से बोल रहा हूँ, सर.
हाँ जी, बोलिए.
जी सर, आपने सर जो ये बुक्स की पूरी मतलब इतने टाइप्स ऑफ बुक बताए कि ये सोर्स पे आप मिल सकता है, तो सर अगर आप एक थोड़ा सा आप एक पीडीएफ हमको अवेलेबल करा दे यूआरएल के साथ, तो सर वो कैनली इजी फॉर अस कि उसको एक्सेस किया जा सकता है, क्योंकि सर वो इतने शॉर्ट टाइम पे नोटिस नहीं कर पाए था सर सभी किताब.
इसका रिकॉर्डिंग आपको अवेलेबल रहेगा, उसमें आप सारा देख सकते हैं. सिद्दीकी जी, सिद्दीका इज आस्किंग कैन वी यूज
ऑल सेकंड सर एक क्वेश्चन और था सर.
बोलिए
सर. ये जो स्रोत गंगा पर ये थेसिस अवेलेबल है, तो सर उससे तो डायरेक्ट कॉपी तो कर नहीं सकते हैं.
क्या नहीं कर सकते?
डायरेक्ट कॉपी करना होगा, जैसे हमसे उससे कुछ मटेरियल लेना है थेसिस से, तो सर वो ओपन रिसोर्स में तो है, लेकिन वो क्यों उन्होंने लिखा
नहीं, पर मैं यूं जानना चाहता हूँ, आप कॉपी क्यों करना चाहते हो?
नहीं सर, कॉपी जैसे आपने कहा कि कहीं जैसे आपने डिफरेंट लाइसेंस के बारे में बताया कि आप वहां से लेकर उसको मॉडिफाई कर सकते हैं, तो लेकिन
वो क्रिएटिव कॉमन्स पे शोध गंगा आपको उसको एक्सेस करने को अलाउ कर रहा है, बट यू कैन नॉट कॉपी मटेरियल फ्रॉम देयर,
बिकॉज़
यू कैन कॉपी इट बाय गिविंग प्रॉपर साइटेशन. इफ यू वांट टू यूज दैट, यू हैव टू यूज इट इन योर ओन वर्ड्स. बड़ा अच्छा क्वेश्चन पूछा है. कैन वी यूज ओईआर मटेरियल इन अवर कोर्स साइट फॉर स्टूडेंट्स? यू शुड पे अटेंशन टू दिस क्वेश्चन बिकॉज दैट आंसर्स सम ऑफ योर क्वेश्चंस व्हिच यू आर गोइंग टू आस्क. इफ देयर इज एनीथिंग व्हिच इज ओईआर इन नेचर, द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज यस. You can use it for your course material. You can download the full course from other website like MIT website. I showed it to you. And you can offer that complete course in your own university. No issue into that. You don't need to create time. Take 1 year in creating your own course. If some other university has created a course which they are offering you as an OER, you just get that material and offer it by following your own process. Academic Council, Board of Studies, whatever you do, yeah, accordingly you can do that. Okay. And then, what are copyleft licenses? Urvashi is asking. Actually, there are some fair use policy or copyleft which allow you to use certain portion of the material, but then there is a ambiguity about what is a reasonable content. If there is a poem of Surendra Sharma ji, चार लाइनें सुना रिया हूं, इफ देर आर ओनली फोर लाइन्स इन ए पोएम एंड यू थिंक दैट व्हाट यू विल यूज, मींस टू क्वांटिफाई अ कंटेंट इज अ लिटिल बिट चैलेंजिंग. इफ यू हैव अ 1000 पेज थीसिस व्हिच इज अलाउड यू टू यूज एंड यू वांट टू टेक फुल 2 पेजेस आउट ऑफ दैट, दैट इज ओके. सो देयर मेयरली समटाइम्स वी सी दैट अराउंड 10%, 4%, 20%, इट डिफर्स फ्रॉम कंट्री टू कंट्री, इंस्टीट्यूशन टू इंस्टीट्यूशन. You need to see that what it allows you to do that.
हेलो सर
जी,
आई एम अभिन बनर्जी फ्रॉम तेजपुर यूनिवर्सिटी
जी.
सर हाउ वी कैन डेवलप द ई मॉड्यूल्स फॉर स्टूडेंट्स एट ग्रेजुएट और पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट एनी टाइप ऑफ लेवल. But what are the necessity or what are the primary criteria to develop e-modules?
I will go with e-modules only in the text format because my other friends, they will take for video or for image, because you must have seen the schedule for today, tomorrow and the day after tomorrow. For that, what you need to do is what are the requirements and necessities are for that. That first, you should prepare your table of content. You should define that under what topic. For example, if I want to teach, say, parts of a plant, so this is my main topic. In that, I will think that I will tell about stem, root, leaf, flower, seed, something. And then I will decide that what kind of content I'm going to take, what I can write on myself. And if I cannot write something myself, if someone else has created that material, which I can take it from there. So I will use that material, which is OER in nature. And you, I have seen you so many websites. From there, you can easily find everything. And in that case, you can use even Google also to search. Let me show it to you how to use Google to search that material, because that will be good for you. And after that, perhaps maybe we can take a break. Please hold on your questions because I cannot see the chat message now when I'm changing my screen. Say this is Google, normal Google, which you everyone uses, and I want to search something on photosynthesis. I'm just taking an example. You can use any of your word. So now it shows me everything available, which may be copyright protected, which I'm not authorized to use, or it may be free, but I do not know. I can simply go to any website and let us see that, can I use it? Britannia Encyclopedia is there. Let us click on it and it will show me the website. But, and here, if you go to the bottom of the page, you can see that by signing up and privacy notes, it is Encyclopedia Britannia. Here is the copyright protected. So it means you cannot just copy and change it from there. Although you can give the reference to it, you can cite it, but you cannot just take this video from here and use it. In that case, what needs to be done? There is an easy way to do that, to use Google for that. What you do, here we are back to our Google search. We have made a search on photosynthesis. Go to settings and go to advanced search. You will see this page. You can directly type Google advanced search. Say like, let me show it to you. If I type Google advanced search, I will again come to the same page. Here or here, the same thing. So you type your keyword and you can then select any language. If you want to search for something, I know that it will show you Hindi also. Here it is in Hindi. So you can see from various languages which has been uploaded available there. You can select your language anytime, any, and you can select any format. You want to search PDF, PPT, whatever. There is a long list of documents kinds available. You want to restrict it. Say, for example, you want to search only PPT. This is the last thing at the end, which is more important for you. Free to share, free to share even commercially, or you want to modify accordingly. If you think that you need to modify your that thing, then you can select it. Otherwise, you just free to use and share.
And
click on advanced search.
अब ये चाहता हूँ कि ये जैसे camp attended वाला है. ये इसके आगे वो बच्चा क्लिक तो कर देगा, ठीक है, लेकिन इसके आगे मैं चाहता हूँ कि वो ये भी भर सके कि भाई उसने कहाँ लगाया और किस डेट को लगाया.
किस चीज के लिए?
ये कैसे भर सकता है वो?
I think some other people are talking among themselves and over again. कौन बोल रहे हैं जरा देखिए
आपके
देव प्रिया घोष इज आस्किंग व्हाट सॉफ्टवेयर इज यूज्ड फॉर प्रिपेयरिंग दोज रिसोर्सेज लाइक फूड चेन गेम. Okay, that was created using articulate storyline. You can make a Google. There are certain e-learning authoring tools which you can create using them, and you can create them. Articulate storyline is a very good software for that. शोध गंगा में जो थीसिस हैं उनमें से कोई चैप्टर डाउनलोड करके स्टूडेंट को शेयर कर सकते हैं. कर सकते हैं आप किसी भी वेबसाइट पे जाएं शोध गंगा पर जाएं प्लीज उनका जो यूज ऑफ टर्म्स है उसको जरूर पढ़ लीजिए एंड देन अकॉर्डिंगली यू नीड टू सी इट. ओके सो मे बी इट इज गोइंग टू बी 12:30 नाउ. प्रोफेसर अमिता जी कैन वी आर वी गोइंग टू टेक ए ब्रेक एंड देन कम फॉर द नेक्स्ट सेशन. साइंस डायरेक्ट की कभी कभी डाउनलोड नहीं हो पाता है. नो इन साइंस डायरेक्ट समटाइम्स इट वोंट अलाउ यू समटाइम्स इट अलाउज यू. यू हैव टू सी दैट ओपन एक्सेस फॉर व्हाट इट इज अवेलेबल. इफ देयर इज एनीथिंग ओपन एक्सेस यू जस्ट सी द साइंस. मेनी ऑफ द इवन सब्सक्रिप्शन बेस्ड पेड बेस्ड जर्नल्स दे अलाउ यू टू हैव ओपन एक्सेस सो दैट वे इट अलाउज यू टू डू दैट. वेयर कैन वी क्रिएट ऑनलाइन क्विज. देयर आर वेरियस रिसोर्सेज यू कैन क्रिएट ऑनलाइन क्विज. Even Google Form is the simple one. You can use Google Form to use it as because it is free. There is another website which is called as Quizzes, quizzes.com. I'm typing it in the chat box and you can visit this website, quizzes.com. Yeah, Kahoot is also there, but if you make a comparison of Quizzes and Kahoot, you will find Quizzes more interesting than Kahoot. Kahoot sometimes confuses the people, but there is a pedagogy behind that because it shows you the answers through four geometrical shapes, circle, triangular, square, and like that. So you need to be remembering that circle stands for which answer and like that.